Google Shopping limited by budget. Should you actually really raise the budget? Most people, when they see this status sign that says limited by budget, okay, I'm going to put a screenshot right here that says status, limited by budget. People who are new to Google Shopping will just rush to add the budget straight away without even thinking twice about it. But hold on to your horses. Limited by budget has two interpretations of it. And only if it falls into the positive category, then should you increase the budget. Otherwise, it's actually not time to increase the budget yet. There are other things you need to do. So let me go into this in this video. I'm going to explain to you what does limited by budget actually means and what you should do about it, how you can analyze it and determine if it's really the right time to increase the budget so you can continue to get shoppers to your store, get sales, and turn it into a profitable campaign. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the RI doctor who helps online stores scale up the Google Shopping campaigns to make it profitable so you can continue to get real shoppers to your store who turns into customers. If you're new to my channel, you might want to check out one of my free resources, which is the Shopify Marketing Guide, which I go into the pros and cons of the different ways to drive traffic to your store, the free ways and the paid ways, so you can decide for yourselves which are the best methods to drive quality traffic to your store so you can continue to get real shoppers and profitable sales. Back to the topic. Limited by budget. Is it really time to increase the budget? Instead of rushing to add on money to your campaign straight away, sit back and watch this video to the end first so you get a better idea of what's actually happening to your campaign right now. When you see these status for your shopping campaign, there are two possible scenarios. I'm going to talk about the positive scenario first, then I'm going to talk about the negative scenario where you are not supposed to increase the budget and what you should do instead. Scenario number one, you have been running your Google Shopping campaign for between like 1 month to 3 months now, and your cost per click is not too high off from 0.66 USD cents, and your click-through rate is not too far away from 0.86%. And looking at your conversion rate of the campaign, we are looking at just maybe under 1% or so, between like maybe 0.7 to 1%. So you are kind of on the right track, and most importantly, you also want to look at your cost per conversion. If you look at your Google Shopping campaign, there's a column called cost per conversion. You want to know, how much does it take to get that one sale or get that one customer who buys something from you? If your cost per conversion is really very, very high, let's say like $100 just to get one customer to buy something from your store, and your average order value of each sale is, let's say, $50, then of course this is not a profitable campaign. There is something wrong with this campaign, because at the rate that this is going, it's not going to help your store to become profitable. I'm going to cover in scenario two at the later part of the video on what to be looking out more for and what you can do. But let's say if your cost per conversion is low, let's say maybe about $20, you're getting $20 for one customer and your average order value is about $50. Well, that's good. That means every one customer you're going to get, which you spend $20 to get, you're going to get $50 from this customer. So you're good, you're in good shape. If your campaign falls into this category, then yes, it's definitely time to add more budget. It's a real case of you need more money so you can get more customers. That's really good. So what you do is you go to your recommendations. So when you click on this recommendation tab in Google Shopping, Google will show you three options of how much you should be increasing your budget by. They give you between like 2 times to 5 times of your budget. Take a second look as well, just to be on the safe side. Look at the cost per conversion column. Look at the third column and see what does it say. If it says for all the three options that Google is giving you, that's either zero, you're not going to cost more per conversion if you add more ad budget into it, or in fact, it becomes minus 50 cents or 20 cents, minus 10 cents. That means as you add more ad budgets costing you less to get each sale, then you're on the right track. Please go ahead to add budget into it. But don't rush to double your budget. What I would recommend is to be on the safe side, add your budget by about 20%. Even though Google is recommending you to add more budget, it sounds like if you add more, you're going to get that number of customers. This is only a prediction based on Google's data set. So it's not 100% guaranteed that that's going to really happen straight away. It's just an estimation or linear extrapolation, what I would say. That means that if you put in this amount, they estimate that's the amount going to get. It's not a guarantee. What I usually recommend for my clients is to add 20% to the current ad budget. And then from there, Google is going to use this additional ad budget to locate more of the similar visitors to your store. If you add more than 20%, what happens is if your campaign is not really going to be able to locate the same type of customers to double the number of profitable customers from what they have seen based on the current performance so far, your cost per conversion might end up to be higher as you add more money suddenly, because suddenly has this excess of budget, they don't really know how to find the right people. However, if you only give a limited amount of budget to the campaign, then Google's algorithm is able to carefully allocate the limited increase in budget to identify the most profitable shoppers to your store. And once you add the budget of 20%, then wait for the algorithm to start doing the training phase again, let the algorithm find the right customers, show your product ads, get the click-through, get the sale for your store. And then after about 14 days, you will be able to see the full impact of what this 20% increase in budget actually means for your store. Once about 14 days is up, between 7 to 14 days, then it's time to go back to review all the indicators that I've mentioned earlier. Look at the click-through rate, look at the cost per click, look at the cost per conversion. So if you see the new cost per conversion is not too far off from the original cost per conversion, that means it's good. The algorithm has managed to identify real similar customers who are going to buy from your store straight away. But that's a good sign. At this time, if your campaign still shows limited by budget, then you can aim for another 20% increase. Then you wait for another 14 days and then you review all the indicators again. So remember, during the 7 to 14 days, don't touch the campaign, don't make any other bidding changes, because this is the time where the algorithm is going to train up. If you make too many changes, that's not helping the campaign. And let's say, for example, you make the bidding changes, you want to change the country, you want to increase the products or decrease the products, then that's really going to affect the campaign's capability to identify the right shoppers to your store. So please don't do anything. Be really patient with your campaign and just monitor and review the performance of your campaign. Okay, and that covers scenario one. Scenario two is when limited by budget means it's still not a good time to increase your budget. And I'm going to tell you what are the things that you should be looking out for. For your campaign, similar to scenario number one, look at your click-through rate, look at your cost per click, look at your cost per conversion and your conversion rate. Look at all these four indicators. So this will give you a fairly good idea. And you can see that maybe the cost per conversion is really, really high, maybe at USD $150 or $200. So each click that eventually turns into a sale is costing you a couple of $100. And your average order value is much, much lower. So it's not a profitable campaign. Likely at this time, you also see a very low conversion rate, maybe 0.5% or less. All of these signs that you're looking at, low click-through rate, high cost per click, high cost per conversion. People who come to your store, if you look at Google Analytics, you can see that most people who come through Google Shopping, they are leaving your store straight away. They land on a couple of products and they leave straight away. So there is something seriously wrong with your campaign. And you need to go back to your shopping feed, which is what's submitted to Google Merchant Center. You need to make sure all your products are optimized. Maybe you need to add the right keywords to your product title. Maybe you need to write more of the product description, improve on it. Maybe you need to submit more attributes for each of your product. And you also, in this case, look at your Google Merchant Center on your diagnostics tab to see if there are any attributes that says limited by performance. So if you see anything that shows like a yellow warning sign, which is typically not a good thing, which means that your Google Shopping ads limited in performance, meaning that if there are other similar products, Google is more likely to show your competitors' products rather than your product. So you need to fix all of those errors on the diagnostics tab. And to improve your product titles and add the right keywords, you want to check out one of my videos where I go into depth into how to optimize your product titles to get Google clicks. Check the video out, link on the top right hand corner of the screen. Another in-depth video where I talk about how to improve your product description, so check that video out, link on the top right hand corner of the screen, where you're going to help your product pages to rank higher on Google, get more clicks. Okay, so each of your product description, you want to aim between 150 to 300 words, which is the most ideal description for your products. And if you're really getting low click-through rate as well, even after you have optimized your product title, that means there could be something really seriously wrong with your product image. You want to really improve on your product image. If you are selling your own product too, and if you didn't hire a professional photographer to take photos of your products, then maybe it's really time to put in the money to hire a real professional or to get someone who actually has like a light box, which can actually make your product shine and look as though the person is holding the product in the hand. You don't want to have blurry pictures, you want to have really close-up photos and how the product is being used. This is really going to help in terms of your click-through rate and conversion rate as well on your store. If you really want to double up and improve the clicks for your Google Shopping campaign, do check out one of my other videos, 13 ways to improve your Google Shopping campaign and get more clicks. Check out the video on the right-hand corner of the screen. I go in-depth into the different attributes that you need to submit for your products and what you should be putting in, so you can help Google to get as much information about your product as possible so they can show them to the right people for the ads. After you follow all of my instructions and recommendations, and then you have let your campaign improve and you are now starting to see improved click-through rate, cost per click, cost per conversion has gone down significantly, hopefully that's nearer or lower than your average order value, then you're actually on the right track. Go to recommendations, zoom in straight to the cost per conversion if you increase your ad budget. If it says 0 + 0 or it says minus, then go ahead to add 20% to the current ad budget. And if not, it still says plus, that means if you're adding more ad budget, it's going to cost you more to get each sale, then no. Go back, you didn't do a good job in improving your titles and description. You need to go back and rework all of those again, update those information, then come back and review these recommendations again. As you can see, optimizing your product feed is not a straightforward process, especially if you have hundreds of thousands of products. It's going to take you a long time to actually optimize every single product. So what I usually recommend my clients is to divide the products into batches, different batch, and you identify those most profitable products first. So you start by optimizing those first, and then you update that into Google Merchant Center and see the improvements slowly work out, and then you continue to work on your other products. If you try to work on all of your products first, one by one, everything before uploading to Google Merchant Center, then that could take you a really, really long time, because optimization, although the word says optimization, it means a constant improvement of the title and description. So that means that if you put it the first time, it could be better than your previous title, but it might not be the best title. So that could be a better title which you can work on, but it needs a bit more brain work. You need to sit around, do some research to see what's the best title or what other words you can add in. So this requires more research, analysis to be able to improve on that. It's as long as your new title is better than the previous title, it means that that's going to improve the performance of your campaign. You divide it into badges, identify the products with the highest price point, most profitable products, you optimize that first, and then you continue and you work on the next batch and the next batch and the next batch, and this is how you will continue to see improvement in your campaign. And if you are not sure which are the products that you should be working on first as well, you can also use Google Analytics as a good indicator to identify which are the products that are getting the clicks from Google Shopping campaign. And the people who's arriving on those products itself, they leave straight away. That means there's something wrong with that product, specific product itself. Identify those products which are getting the most clicks from Google Shopping campaign. You can start working on those first. So the key thing is, the clearer, more detailed, more in-depth information about your product that you are giving to Google Merchant Center, the more likely that the algorithm is going to learn to be able to show your product ads to the right people who are most interested in your products. That means you're likely to get more clicks and these people are more likely to buy. The less information you have, then Google's algorithm is unable to work out who is your product supposed to be for, who should they show it to, what are the people typing into Google before they should show your products. So Google's algorithm is confused. There is no trick here. The thing is just to put in as much information as possible. That's it. I hope that gives you a very clear, detailed idea of what goes on behind the scenes for Google Shopping optimization work. It's not that straightforward, and it's not just a let it run and I'll just put in more money and it's going to get more sales. It doesn't quite work like that. You need to put in time and effort to put in the details and make your product information as complete as possible. If that's all too much for you and you feel that you can't really cope by yourself, you need help, get in touch with me. I help Shopify store owners to scale up their Google Shopping campaign to get onto the next level, to optimize their products. So you can get in touch, link in the description and pinned comments. And don't forget to download my Shopify marketing guide, where I go into details of different ways to drive free and paid traffic to your store so you're not totally reliant on Google. Because during holidays time, you might actually have to put in more budget to outbid your other competitors in the space. So if you want to really make sure you're not 100% reliant on Google, do really download my Shopify marketing guide. And if you found this video useful and valuable for you, remember to give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos of how to scale up your shopping campaign to get more visitors and sales for your store. I'm Claire Ritten, the Outlier Doctor, signing off. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I'm not the only one.